I want to invite my good friends, the clowns. Please.
Bon appetit. evening, ladies and gentlemen. Gita and Jack Nagel, thank you very much for being here with all your family. It's a very important evening for us and for the children of Jerusalem. It is my pleasure to welcome the Deputy Minister of Health, who is actually the Acting Minister of Health, Rav Yaakov Litzman, who is a good friend, personal and of the hospital, the Mayor of Jerusalem, Mr. Nir Barkat. I will be very brief because both of our distinguished guests will have to leave after they say a few words. Next Shabbat is Parashat Shoftim. It's going to be Shabbat Shaarei Tzedek in the Great Synagogue in Jerusalem. So I will say a few words there about Parashat HaShavua. And now when we are dedicating the Wilf Children's Hospital and mainly the Nagel's floor, I would like to move to the next Shabbat's parasha, Parashat Ki Tetze. And there we read, Ki Tivne Bayit Chadash Ve'asita Ma'akeh Legagecha Ve'lo Titen Damim Beveitecha Ki Yipol Hanofel Mimenu. Translation to English is, when you build a new house, you shall make a guardrail for your roof so that you shall not cause blood to be spilled in your house, that the one who falls should not fall from it. We are building a new house, a new building, a new house and a new home for the sick children of Jerusalem today. And the inpatient floor of the hospital is dedicated today by the Nagel family, and we have the pleasure to have the whole tribe here. And really thank you for bringing everybody along. Those of you who participated in the tour of the department, and I invite the Deputy Minister and Mayor of Jerusalem to take a tour of this floor because it's an amazing floor. It's a floor that represents actually a new standard and a new concept in treating those who are the most difficult patients. I always say that every person that crosses the doorstep of our hospital or any other hospital is immediately going into an anxiety state. That's by definition. The main wish of someone who crosses as a patient the doorstep of the hospital is to be out of the hospital before he enters it. So it's the main task of a hospital not only to offer top professionalism and the best equipment, which we have all through our departments, but to offer also relief and alleviation of this anxiety state. Those of you who tour this floor could be impressed that not only top people, top physicians, top nurses, top paramedical personnel are serving the patients in this floor, but the floor was designed in a manner that is extremely children's friendly. And we invested a lot of money, part of it inspired by the Nagels, Gita and Jack, in order to be children friendly and to relieve and alleviate the anxiety of the children. You saw the big school that we have. You saw the decoration, which is unbelievable. You saw the pet therapy, which is not found in any other children's hospital, probably only in few children's hospitals in the world. And in the couple of months that this floor is open and serves the children of Jerusalem, we realize on a daily basis how much this simple modality, having few pets, a parrot, rabbits on the floor, with a specialist in pet therapy, the impact of the anxiety of the children is unbelievable. So we continue here a tradition, not only of top professional care and top people, but also of the empathy, of the humane, individualized care that characterizes this institution for the 113 years since its inception. And mentioning this, I would like to pay tribute to my colleague and friend, Professor Yechiel Schlesinger, who is the medical director of this new facility, and who is in charge of all the professional aspects, including the empathy and the humane individualized care. and to show you how God works. We don't understand, but we know the facts. We are actually closing a circle today. We have the honor to have the parents, the father, the parents of Professor Schlesinger here, Rabbi Schlesinger, and the grandfather, whose Yuletide was yesterday, was the second Director General of Shaarei Tzedek Medical Center and ran the hospital from 1948 to 1967. One of the virtues of this hospital is that it retains its employees. Almost everybody comes happy to work every day. So in 113 years of existence, I am the only the fourth Director General. The first one was Dr. Wallach, who ran the hospital from 1902 to 1947. The second one was Dr. Schlesinger of blessed memory, as I said, from 48 to 67. Then came Professor Meir, and we have the honor to have his wife, Sheila, here with us. And as we inaugurate every new department in the hospital, this hospital, although it's a new building, is also part of the vision of the late Professor David Meir, who in the mid-70s had the vision to build a hospital that was at that time less than 300 beds on an area and with a footage that can accommodate a 750-bed hospital. Together with Bikur Cholim, we are now close to 1,000-bed hospital. So this is also the opportunity to pay tribute to the late Professor David Meir. And I have quite a long list, and I will like to finish within 2 or 3 minutes, of people who worked very, very hard in order to be able for us and for the children to get to this day when we present the children of Jerusalem with such a wonderful present. So I thank the Ministry of Health, Rabbi Litzman, because without the licensure, without your personal support and the support of your staff, we won't be here today. We thank the municipality of Jerusalem because you are the municipality of Jerusalem and we are a Jerusalem hospital. We like to call ourselves the Hospital of Jerusalem. And I'm sure you will confirm this title when you come in a few minutes here. I would like to thank the architects of this building who are designing and building all our new projects since the early 90s, including the very famous Jesselson Heart Center, the Wilf Women and Infant Center, our auditorium, and tens of other smaller projects. And I think Zvika Rubinstein and Shai Ofer, this is the jewel in your crown. Those of you who saw the decoration of the hospital, of the children's hospital, that was done by the acrylicized company from London, would appreciate how unique it is. And I would like to thank Paul Arad, who represents acrylicized and is here with us today. I would like to thank the building company, Margolin Brothers, and Mr. Amir Alperovich, who was the head of this project from the outside builders. And of course, the project department, I would call it the project wing, here at Shaarei Tzedek, headed by my deputy and the CFO of the hospital, Mrs. Ruth Ralbag, who did a terrific job all along and definitely in order to be ready for that day. I would like to thank the Dalet Yamin Company, Electra, Elmore, and many, many other outside contractors who were in charge of the project. And I would like to thank, I would say first and foremost, the staff of the Children's Hospital and the staff of the Nagel's floor. Physicians, nurses, paramedical personnel, supportive staff, cleaners, who all did a terrific job in order to be able to inaugurate this floor. And of course, my colleagues in the management of the hospital, the logistics department of the hospital, the IT department. You cannot build a modern facility today without heavy involvement of information technology, the admission department headed by Mrs. Sarah Noam. And I would like to mention just as a concluding remark that we are inaugurating the 7th floor, but I want to thank you, Jack and Gita, for bringing along Rabbi Friedman, Jacob Friedman from Los Angeles, who will be dedicating his floor later in December, which is the outpatient floor of the hospital that is built to the same level. So thank you all for being here tonight, for celebrating with us and with the children of Jerusalem. It is my pleasure now to call upon Rabbi Litzman to address our distinguished audience.
My dear Mayor of Jerusalem, I'll try to speak in English. Mr. Ner Barkat, we'll try. You know, I failed my regents. I didn't fail, but I wasn't so good. That's why I became a minister. So, dear Mayor Ner Barkat, General Director of the Hospital, Yonatan Halevi, the Nagel family, dear friends and supporters of the hospital. You know, since Professor Levy started with Dvar Torah, I'll have to come along with him together. I'd like to say something about him, about himself. Parshat HaShavua, from this week, Shoftim, the Torah learns us to take a king. If you want to make a king, the Torah tells us how to make a king. Who can be a king? The Torah tells us also a certain word, it says in the Torah, Vaya kishifto al kisei mamlachto. Kishifto al kisei mamlachto. So a lot of Sfarim, rabbis, ask, why do we have a language from kishifto? When he's sitting there, he should do not a lot of money, you know, a lot of horses, a lot of things there. What's the language what the Torah says? Keshifto. So one of the perushim which I heard, a king, and same thing with a minister. When he comes into office, he wants to make tochniot. Plans, yes. He has a lot of plans. He wants to build buildings, he wants to build houses, he wants to build streets. He doesn't know, that's the first day. It goes past a week, it goes past a month, 3 months. You know, he has a very different plans. His plans have changed already. He's now, he can't build all the streets, buildings, but he's going to make something. The more time that it passes by, the more he cools off. So the Torah tells us, Vayaki Shifto, at the same day when he got the seat, that he wants to make plans, it should be the whole life. That he should be warm and should be taking care of everything. The same at the first day. Professor Halevi, he's working now, I don't know how much years, but it's like the same first day when he came into the office here. And he's doing everything, and I can tell you one thing here, the Nagel family, I understand that you got into this business here 7 years ago. That time he was the second driver, he's the first driver today already. Shaar HaTzedek Hospital is not what it was. It has changed altogether. A lot of reasons which are not so good because of Hadassah maybe, but it's also quite sure because of himself also. What he's doing to the hospital. I've helped a lot in this hospital. I don't want to go into details. Not so much money-wise, a little bit money-wise, but more in permits and more with whatever you have to give here to the hospital, which is not easy for me. But I did it. And I'm planning and trying to help it also because I think we need a strong Shaar HaTzedek Hospital and we will have it. That's why I think that the Nagel family has done a very good iska. And I know this hospital very well. I come here quite surprise visits, not they're going to have one of the surprise visits also another time. Not. I can tell you something which nobody knows, that a few weeks ago I was almost here with Prime Minister Netanyahu on a surprise visit here. The last minute it changed. So I'd like to thank you very much for helping the hospital and took your time just to say how good a business you've done. You're a good businessman. And I hope that Hashem will give you a lot of more healthy years. You know, I'm a deputy minister. I hope I will stay deputy. I don't know what the High Court's going to say. But I just can bless you. We'll have a good year for all of you, for all of everybody who's helping the hospital. And thank you very much what you have done.
Thank you very much, Rabbi Litzman, the Deputy Minister of Health, for your kind remarks.